Aaron Burnett Out Front, weeknights at 7, only on CNN.
There wasn't one person that went into that ER. There were three.
Jeremy Stotchill's wife, Lori, 7 months pregnant with his twin boys. It was New Year's Day 2006. Lori was vomiting and couldn't breathe. Jeremy rushed her to St. Thomas More Hospital in Canyon City, Colorado.
Lori looked up at me, and then her head went down on her chest.
In the lobby of the emergency room, she went into full cardiac arrest from a pulmonary embolism. Lori Stotchill, just 31 years old, died. And so did her 28-week-long unborn twins.
I didn't even get to hold them. I have an autopsy picture. That's all I've got.
Stotchill sued the hospital and its owner, Catholic Health Initiatives, which operates nearly 80 hospitals in 14 states. He filed the wrongful death suit on behalf of his wife and his unborn twin sons. In court, he was stunned to learn the hospital's defense.
How many people does the hospital say you lost that day?
One. Since they weren't born, they weren't people. They did not qualify as a person.
That's right. Catholic Health Initiatives has argued that under Colorado law, to be a person, one must at some point have been born alive. A glaring contradiction to Catholic Church teachings, which says life begins at conception. Catholic Health Initiatives would not speak to CNN on camera, but said in a statement, "In this case, as Catholic organizations, we are in union with the moral teachings of the church." That doesn't appear to add up in this case. As a Catholic organization, the hospital is supposed to follow the church's teachings laid out in the ethical and religious directives from the U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops. No abortions, no contraceptives, no direct sterilization like vasectomies. And it clearly states, Catholic Health Ministry witnesses to the sanctity of life from the moment of conception until death. While the moral debate continues, so does Jeremy Stotchill's legal battle. After he lost in the lower courts, the defense lawyers for the doctors and the hospital owned by Catholic Health Initiatives went after him for $118,000 in legal fees, garnishing his wages.
Okay, bye.
He's now bankrupt and struggling to care for his daughter, 9-year-old Libby, on his own.
Tears, the pain, the heartache. Still, 7 years later.
That pain is why he won't give up. He's now appealing to Colorado Supreme Court, asking them to decide if his sons were people under the state's laws.
Will it make you feel better to get some sort of answer from the Catholic Church?
I don't know. Perhaps it'll be closure.
A permanent reminder next to his heart.
That's the footprints of the boys?
A tattoo. Two sets of footprints. And the words, our sons, children in his eyes, fighting to get a state and church institution to see them that way as well.
Kyung, it's just a heartbreaking story. Looking at Jeremy there, what does he say the hospital could have done to save his twins' lives?
What he's saying is that the hospital could have tried. What Jeremy Stotchill is arguing is that his wife was already in the ER when she went into cardiac arrest, and that the hospital could have tried to do an emergency C-section. Medical experts will tell you that you have 5 minutes before the children suffer some sort of brain damage, before the fetuses suffer brain damage. And he wants that answer, but he believes that the only way he'll get that answer is by going to court. And Aaron, he says he simply cannot seem to get there. Judges keep wanting to dismiss this case.
And I know that the bishops of Colorado have now weighed in. What are they saying to you?
This is a very important development because it does appear, Aaron, that the bishops are beginning to rethink all of this. Look at the statement that they released late last night. In the statement, and these are the Colorado bishops, they are saying, we will undertake a full review of this litigation and of the policies and practices of Catholic Health Initiatives to ensure fidelity and faithful witness to the teachings of the Catholic Church. So it certainly looks like they are at least going to reconsider all of this legal action.